Right, ladies and gentlemen, we're at BPM NEC 2012 on 823 DJstands.com stand, and we're looking at some of these rather nice units that can only be described as work. I would class them as works of art. What do you reckon?
I'd agree with that.
They are
amazing works of art.
They are, and they are made, designed, built, the whole shebang in the United Kingdom.
And by this me.
By you. All right, what's your name, sir?
Paul Foster.
And explain, what have you got to do with these guys? You have near enough said, but, you know, what have you done here?
Yeah, we basically get feedback as a result of 4 years' worth of shows here at the NEC. Again, loads of feedback off the end users to see what gaps there are in the market that we can slot into. There's a lot of stands out there, a lot of booths out there, but this is more of a facade, this particular product. This is called the MS1.
Okay.
The MS standing for modesty screen.
Yeah.
To hide all your clutter, all your junk behind it, basically.
Yeah.
It's designed to fit around a standard 6-foot buffet table that you find in most venues. But the plan is you set this screen up, first of all. It takes about 3 to 4 minutes. And then you can get to work behind it, setting up your own gear.
Yeah.
You don't have to worry about all the eyes looking at you, especially at a wedding venue.
Yes.
Watching you set up. And you can have it as messy as you like, obviously, behind here, and no one need know.
Yeah, it is very beautiful. I love the effect with the LED behind that.
Yeah, there's a few design changes we made after showcasing it at the Cedar Show earlier this year. So down the bottom here, you've got an extender plate. So the whole unit here can rise or lower by that, which is about 150 millimetres.
Yeah.
We've got a plate here, so if you wanted to put your logo or telephone number, roadshow name, whatever, that's what that's for.
Yeah.
Basically, it screws together very quickly. Just flush head M6 threaded nuts through here, which with wing nuts on the other side.
Yeah.
So, yeah,
it does look beautifully. I can see this working very well for a mobile DJ who predominantly does, say, weddings.
Yeah. I mean, that's what we're trying to target this weekend. But it is available in any colour, no extra cost if you wanted it, red, black, whatever.
Beautiful.
And if your budget allows, we can get this laser cut with your name or venue details in.
Very nice.
Just need a DXF standard farm. And we've also done the columns here, so.
Like it.
It's designed to be straight out of the box, light show almost. So if you've got four small moving heads, such as these.
Yes.
Yeah, that's the back of the unit.
Yeah.
Basically, put a column either side of this, have your moving heads on there.
Yeah.
Or if you want to put these columns at the other end of the room, for instance, you're then taking over the whole room with your setup.
I mean, I'm thinking out loud now, a setup like that, we've got the moving heads on each column. No reason at all why you probably couldn't have a column there with a small speaker on top.
Yeah.
You know, I'm sure that could be done. It looks good. I can see as well, visualize, tripod with a Scrim King, 12 or 15 on the top of that.
Yeah.
You've got your LEDs here, a bit of uplighting around the room, a couple of moving heads. That's all you need, isn't it? Less is more, you know. It's the appearance and the professionalism of, you know, not much kit.
Exactly, and I think a lot of the wedding guys, they're all caught on to the fact that just chuck a few LED bars around the room, uplight the whole room, it looks a lot more classy than 20 or so effects on a goalpost.
Yes.
For some people. Another point actually, the wedding DJs came up this weekend. It's like it or not, you're going to be in the photos at some point, wedding photos for the first dance, etc. So if you've got the bride and groom doing their thing in front of this, you know, it blends in. You're not going to see a load of cables. So
yes,
it's good for the wedding fairs as well.
Yes. Fantastic. And how can people get hold of this product and other products that you design and sell?
Straight to the website,
djstands.com.
Some of the products, like the ring stand, are only available from retailers, and you'll find a list of those on the website.
Okay.
So obviously the ring stand's been around a few years now, and that's been going really well for us.
Yeah, I like that. That's saving a lot of space, isn't it? Beautiful.
we do it at the Matrix stand, but that's not here at the exhibition, run out of proof.
Okay.
And that's a new product as well this year, the Reach stand.
Like it.
Comes with two different top plates. You can either have it to hold two laptops. It comes as a single arm version as well. So you've got a height, reach, tilt, pan adjustment on every access plate.
Nice. Sweet.
It doesn't need to be bolted down. It's all freestanding.
Ah, lovely. Very good.
It's nice and sturdy as well.
Yeah. Excellent.
And yeah, this is the MB1 booth, which is again new this year. Last year we just had a facade here and was getting feedback off the mobile guys to see how they wanted us to produce it. So again, just simple up lighting from underneath it.
Yeah.
Crouch light onto the screen. It's available with or without these screens. These just lift off. So
nice. What's the setup time like on this then, roughly?
About 5 minutes.
That's not too bad.
All our products now, they come with optional carry cases.
Okay.
As well as the facade behind you, that comes with carry cases.
And nice.
Transport, so
lovely.
They're keenly priced as well.
Yeah. All right, well, Paul, as ever, it's a pleasure. Thank you very much indeed. I will put a clickable hyperlink in the description that will take you directly to this gentleman's website, also his email, so if you do want to get in touch, you can do so. Shall I bung your phone number in there as well to the company?
Yeah, why not? Yeah.
All right, we'll put the phone number in there as well, and as ever, practice and
enjoy.
Thank you.